Now, the Quad nations have signed a semiconductor cooperation pact. The ministers were, in fact, discussing technological issues in the upcoming meeting, and that will be part of that discussion. In fact, there has been a statement that's released by the U.S. Indo-Pacific Affairs Director as well. For that, and for more details on that very story, my colleague Akanksha Swaroop is with us. Akanksha, India, U.S. and the other Quad countries inking that entire semiconductor fabrication plant and the pact for it, and leading towards national security, or probably and also next generation telecom, is something that has been an underlined aspect of this particular meet, and something that we will see, you know, as far as this upcoming meet also is concerned. Just take our viewers through what exactly does this communication really say.
Right. There were a host of discussions, you know, of course, security remains a prime concern. Countering terrorism remains a prime concern. Maritime security has been a prime concern. There was also discussion on health, pandemic preparedness. Mpox was also discussed. Having said that, you know, we've seen how President Biden has, in fact, also increase the engagement level of the Quad from a meeting to making it a summit. So President, the U.S. President, very keen on leaving something behind in terms of his legacy, which is why there has been so much focus on critical and emerging technology. The Quad has been working in lockstep to stay at forefront of technology and innovation. It remains committed to harnessing emerging technologies that also includes open radio access network. As you rightly mentioned, yes, there was a lot of talk about semiconductors, which even our Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi talked about. He said that, you know, they will also be working, India per se, will be working towards coming up with a chip. As far as semiconductors are concerned, they welcome the finalization of a memorandum of cooperation for semiconductor supply chain contingency network. This will be facilitating collaboration in addressing semiconductor supply chain risks, which, remember, have been partially also taken over or disrupted by China. We've seen that battle going on between China and Taiwan. And there's always also been focus on even artificial intelligence through the advancing innovations for empowering next-gen agriculture. There's a lot of focus on technology when it comes to artificial intelligence. In fact, the Quad has also announced inaugural $7.5 million in funding opportunities for joint research, and even highlighted signing of a memorandum of cooperation among the four countries of Quad. So technology per se, Griha, has been a focal point for the Quad this year.
Absolutely. Akanksha, I'd request you to stay on with us. We're getting some more breaking news now.